M23 rebels are just several dozen kilometers from here, Goma, where some 60 more Kenyan soldiers have deployed. The commander of the Seven Nation Bloc's East African Community's military force in the Democratic Republic of Congo is vowing to protect the key eastern city threatened by the advance. No one will take Goma, says Kenyan General Jeff Nyaga.
Have one mandate. That is to conduct joint operations with our brothers in DRC, to support the DDR program, and to work very closely with humanitarian agencies. And therefore, I don't believe as a force commander, anybody is going to operate outside that mandate.
About 100 Kenyan troops arrived in the city over the weekend as part of a new East African Community military operation aiming to stabilize Eastern DRC. East African leaders agreed to establish a military force for Eastern DRC in April, but its intended size and scope remain unclear. I hope that with your arrival many things will change and we will evolve into an offensive mission to bring peace to our country, the DRC, with M23 and this Rwandan aggression as a priority, including the FDLR as well as the rest of the local armed groups. Nyaga describes the EAC force as an intervention force rather than a peacekeeping force, but he emphasizes that finding a political solution to the crisis and disarming rebels would take priority over fighting. If we do not find a political or diplomatic solution, because that is the priority, if they refuse to lay down their arms, then we will have no choice but to use force. The deployment of troops from the EAC bloc comes as M23 rebels have surged across the DRC's North Kivu province, capturing swathes of territory in recent weeks. On Wednesday, the rebel group announced that it had captured Kibumba, a settlement about 20 kilometers from Goma. The DRC's army has not yet officially communicated on the rebel advance. A mostly Congolese Tutsi group, the M23, first gained prominence in 2012 when it briefly captured Goma before being driven out and going to ground. The group re-emerged late last year, taking up arms again on claims that the DRC had failed to honor a promise to integrate them into the army, among other grievances.